Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world, whenever you're watching this YouTube video. Welcome to the Bitcoin Family YouTube channel. For the newcomers, my name is Didi. Today, short, powerful TA video. I think six amazing charts that you need to see. So let's quickly jump into it because I want to keep it short and powerful. Here we go.
Bam. I've been down so long that my mind can't get no rest. Easy, darling, 'cause the devil's on my trail.
First chart, guys, this is of course the day chart. Of course, normally you open with a 4-hour chart, Didi. Today with a day chart. Why? Because you can see that long over here that we opened because of the Bam Bam indicator, we are seeing this green cloud in the back becoming thinner and thinner, which could mean we would converge into a red cloud, and that would be the moment you will see a short flag. You need to wait till the day is completely over. Bam, just when we were talking about it, it is happening. You see this? Just when we were talking about it, the short flag appeared on the screen. You see the red cloud, but we need to wait till the closing of that day. Then, if we see the closing of the day, we look to the bottom, we look, okay, is it still green or are we going to go yellow? Is the Bam Bam and the bottom crossing that gray line? And that would be the moment of exiting your trade or your spot trade or your leverage rate on this day chart. Really cool. Next chart, bam. Over here, we can see on the 1-hour chart that we are fighting this area of resistance over here till 57,400. If we break that, then there is not much resistance left on the top. Oh, on the bottom, guys, you can see the new Bam Bam indicator. We have a new Bam Bam indicator, and also we have a complete new Bitcoin Family happy indicator. But go to the Discord server or to thebitcoinfamily.com for more information. But if we break this, there is not much resistance left. That does mean we could go easily to 60k like that. That is also what you see on this chart, a huge, huge red area over there that we completely broke through. And the red area is becoming thinner and thinner. And the green area is also becoming thinner and thinner, but the volume mostly just appears out of nothing. And then bam, you break to that 57, 58k level to take it all the way up to 60k, and above 60k, resistance will be built. But you can see what is happening. Every time when we break it, we go higher. So I see a very bullish opinion at the moment, guys. Let's say it like this. And because of this one as well, the Gaussian channel that's going to close in 16 hours. If in 16 hours this candle closes above the Gaussian channel, no wick touching it, bullish as beep fuck. So really interesting to watch all these charts, guys. And also the weekly chart, like I said, very positive looking. We will close this candle in 5 days. We need to close it above the logarithmic growth curve line, the midline of it, and that would be very bullish. At the bottom, we have this indicator over there. I will show you, this is the NVHV, so you can see and put them on your own trading view. NVHV combo, as long this one stays red, this is very bullish. The moment we turn white, bearish. Here on the bottom, you have the stock RSI, also very bullish in my opinion. Oh my god, was my face all the time in the mid of the screen. This is terrible. Oh, Didi. But guys, I don't have time. I don't have time. I really don't have time to redo the video. So let's see what happens. Sorry for that, but I hope you still enjoyed it. Give it already a thumbs up. But let's go back to where I were. Didi, you were here. So this one, stock RSI, blue crossing red, very positive. And here on the bottom, of course, also very positive. The RSI, yes, going up. And we are above that beautiful level now of 63, which is very bullish, guys. Now, let's quickly jump into those amazing other charts that I want to share with you. I'm getting sick of the flies over here. I'm leaving to Dubai tomorrow, so that will be solved. Keeping it short, guys, don't talk so much. Let's jump into the other stuff. Bam. Okay, over here, this chart, really cool chart. Why is this really cool chart? This is the Bitcoin halving index. The blue line is the first halving, the red line the second halving, the white line the third halving. As you can see, the first halving started in November, the second halving started in July, and the third halving started in May. This is the amount of days it took till the top. So the blue line, it took 370 days to go times 92 from the halving. The red line, it took 526 days to go times 30 from the halving. The white line now, we already are at 518 days to only go times 6.7. If you look at this part, you can see that there's a blow off top. You can also see that over here. We haven't seen that over here yet. So yes, this area still needs that jump, maybe till 16 times, you know, or something from the halving, which would be above $130,000. And to see this, because people ask me always, when will the peak be again in December? How is it possible? Now that's because possible because you can see the runs are taking longer from the halving. And that is what you see on this chart over here. On this chart, you can see perfectly that the first halving started in December, then in August, and now this one in May. But the first two, they've both ended between November and December. This one, if we would need to end like the first two, we should be ending somewhere in November to December, which would mean that the Bitcoin price would do something like that, something like that. And then we reach 137,400, which is also Plan B's model. Really, really cool. Guys, then we have another really awesome chart. That is this one. This chart is very interesting because, and the transfer volume by size is really interesting to see that the large transactions are going up tremendously. So these volume, 10 million plus, are growing. You can see this line, the dark green is going up, up, up. There are more 10 million plus transactions being done than the very small ones. The small ones, 0 to 1K or 1K to 10K, that area above, the red to the yellow one, is becoming smaller and smaller and smaller, and the greens are becoming bigger and bigger and bigger, while I'm becoming eaten by the fucking flies. Then the last shot, guys, bam, keeping it short. I really like this one as well, because on this one you see the top line is a 2012 cycle, the bottom line is the blue bottom line is a 2016 cycle. We started above the cycles, then we went into that average, then here we were almost the same as the 2016 cycle. We were below both cycles, and now we are crossing into the 2016 to 2012 cycle. In average, if we would stay around the 2016 cycle, we would end up somewhere over there, 180K. We could also in average out between the two cycles, because the whole bull run we were in between the two cycles, and then we would average out somewhere there between the 150 and the 288K. Bam, that was my last chat. I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy the video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and please leave that comment, as I love to read and to respond to your comments. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow again. Maybe the video will be a little bit later tomorrow, as I'm traveling in the car and all that stuff, but I will see you tomorrow. Thanks for watching, and see you later. Bam.